Welcome back, guys. So in this lecture, we will discuss the introduction of part of network synthesis. Okay, until now, we have seen different topics like balanced three-phase, unbalanced three-phase, the graph theory, and network transients analysis, two-port networks, and this is the final unit, that is network synthesis. So in this network synthesis, you have basic topics like this is actually the concept which is useful for your control systems. You will be understanding that. In the first thing, you have you have to know what is positive real function. Okay? And you will be going to know what is basic synthesis, basic synthesis procedure. Okay, so you have to know, you are going to know the procedure for synthesis. So for what you will know, going to know the procedure for synthesis means for LC emittance. So for the LC emittance function, you will have LC emittance function. RC means, you know that, resistance and capacitor. RC impedance function and RL, contradiction of RC impedance function is RL admittance function. Okay, this is also another topic. And again, you will be going to learn about LC impedance function. So what is meant by LC impedance function, and contradiction of LC impedance function is RC admittance function. So for these functions, you will synthesize the network. Okay, for all LC impedance function, RC impedance function, and RL admittance function, RL admittance impedance function, and RC admittance function, these are three functions you are going to know about. By all these things will be knowing by, you have two forms, that is Foster forms, Foster and Coyer form. Okay, Foster, by using Foster and Coyer forms, you will be knowing what is a, you will be doing synthesis of LC. So you will be getting what is inductor capacitor circuit, resistant capacitor circuit with impedance function, and resistor inductor circuit with impedance function, and RL impedance function. So in Foster and Coyer forms. Okay, so this is the syllabus for your network synthesis. So before going to jump into the entire concept, let me know about your what is meant by network analysis. So in your network theory circuits, if you have a circuit like this, it may be inside this circuit you may have a T circuit, pi circuit, or whatever the circuits. We have many different kinds of circuits. So in that, what is given is input is given for you. Okay, so the input may be a voltage source or current source, whatever it may be. Here the input we take in this consider is R of S, or we'll take it as Q of S. So differently, will different functions, different test books will follow different things, and R of S or Q of S, and you will be getting output for that system. So simply, if you take a series RLC circuit, R circuit, that is R1, R2, in network analysis, what is given is, you will be given a voltage source, let us say this is 10 volts, and you will be asking to find the voltage across R2 or current flowing through this circuit. So if it is 10 volts, if for example, if it is taking 5 ohms and this is 5 ohms, then your current may be I equal to what, 1 amp is flowing, and V2 equal to equal resistance means equal voltage division. So V2 is 5 volts. So these are analysis things. So what you are analyzing is how much current it is flowing and what is the voltage across this. So the circuit is given for you and the input is given for you, and we are getting the response. This is about network analysis. Now coming to network synthesis, you will be given a source function or a source. It may be R of S or Q of S, and you also be given the response. So response may be a P of S or a function or C of S. Okay, you have to find the circuit. This is the big deal. Okay, so finding the circuit is not an important, not a simple thing. So for finding the circuit, you will be given a positive real function. What I am saying is, before, this is the positive, by using the positive real function, okay, you will be finding the circuit. So by using positive, so you have many real functions, basic upon their demand and basic upon their utilization, you will have different positive real function. You will be giving a function and you will be asking to find the circuit. Okay, so here we are going to do know what is about positive real function. Okay, so in the next class we will knowing about what is positive real function, and we have this side, we have separate conditions and we have properties about positive real function. We'll discuss in that later. Thank you guys. This is about introduction of network synthesis, and we are going to learn about these topics in coming lectures. Thank you guys.